In this video, you will learn how to build your first no-code AI agent using n8n, step by step. This is probably the most valuable skill you can learn right now. Why? Because the demand is exploding and AI automations unlock crazy leverage. When my business blew up overnight, I was buried in repetitive tasks. I thought automation was the answer. But I still had to pay developers $150 an hour, explain every detail and wait for weeks. Then I found n8n, a no-code tool I can combine with AI. It was an absolute game changer. I could build, test and launch ideas quickly while reducing costs significantly. All by my own without any coding. By the end of the video, you will know exactly how to set up your own AI agent, even if you never touched code before.
But before we begin, make sure to open up the Google Docs document linked in the description below. It has all the prompts and templates you need to follow along. First, we want to create an n8n account. For that, we go to n8n.io, click Get Started, and fill out the form. And start the free trial. Just answer these questions real quick. Click here Skip, and wait for your workspace to start up. Click Start Automating. Now we can easily create our first workflow by clicking Create Workflow. First, let's give our workflow a name like To-Do List Manager. The first thing we have to do when we create a workflow is to add a trigger. For that, we click Add First Step. And now we can choose a trigger for this workflow. We have different options. We can select trigger manually. That means we just press a button and start it. We have on app event. It's like when a new WhatsApp message arrives or a Telegram message or when something happens in your Google Drive, for example. We have on schedule. That means it can run every day, every hour or in any other interval that you choose. These ones are not interesting for us right now and we choose on chat message. Here we don't have to fill out anything and go back to Canvas. Now we have a button that says Open Chat. When we click on it, a chat opens. This is like ChatGPT, where we can type anything like, hey. But right now, nothing happens since we don't have it connected to anything. So we close it and click the plus icon here. Here we select AI and AI agent. For now, we don't have to fill out here anything and click go back to Canvas. The first thing we have to do is to add a chat model. Otherwise, our AI agent has no brain. So we click the plus icon under chat model and look for OpenAI, since we're using ChatGPT in this example. Here we have to fill out our credentials under create new credentials. And for that, we need an API key. To get an API key, we go to platform.openai.com, create an account or sign in. Important side note, this is not the same like your personal ChatGPT account, so you need to create here a new account. Then you go to settings.
Just make sure that you have some credits on your account. For that, you click to billing and add some credits like 5 or 10 bucks.
Go to API keys and create a new secret. Give it any name, n8n, AI agent for example. Select the project and click create secret key. This key you copy, paste it under API key and click save. If everything worked fine, you should see connection tested successfully. Now our OpenAI chat model is working. We go back to Canvas. Let's click now open chat and try again. Hey, how are you doing? And like you can see, our AI agent is using now the ChatGPT AI model to give us an answer. I'm just a program, but I'm here and ready to help you. It's like ChatGPT, perfect. We hide the chat for now and click save. We just set up something really powerful with just a few clicks. Let me show you why. When we turn on this workflow by clicking here and make the chat public by selecting this element, by selecting make chat publicly available, we receive a public URL here. For now, we leave the settings here like default, so the initial message will be, hi there, my name is Nathan, how can I assist you today? Let's change it to add. Go back to Canvas, make sure that you click save, and now let's open this public URL in the web browser. Now you see a simple chat interface. That means you now have your own chatbot. You can share this link with anyone and they can chat with your AI agent already. A common use case for this is customer support. You can even add this chatbot to your website, but we'll save that for another video. So yes, you just built a chatbot, no tech skills needed. Right now it's still very basic, but don't worry, by the end of this video it will be much smarter.
And if you're serious about learning this topic with real-world examples, then join my private community. It's built for fast results with my direct guidance, plug-and-play templates that you can adjust in minutes, and a team of truly ambitious builders. Right now you get direct access to me, your personal AI consulting expert, without paying ridiculous amounts of money.
Now let's give our AI agent some tools to work with. But first let's go to our Google Docs document and open the Google Sheets document there. Here you can find it directly in the beginning. Make a copy of this document and copy the URL. We will need it in a few seconds. We want now to give our AI agent access to our Google Sheets document. For that, we click the plus icon under Tool and look for Google Sheets Tool and click on it. First, we need to set up our credentials. For that, we click Create New Credentials and click Sign In with Google. When everything worked fine, you should see the message Account Connected. Tool description and resources we leave as it is. Under Operation, we choose Get Rows, and for Document, we choose By URL and paste our URL here. Under Sheet, we select From List and choose Tasks. Good, that's it, and we click Go Back to Canvas. Now our AI agent can read your to-do lists and answer questions about your tasks. Let's test it out. For that, we open a chat again and ask which tasks are due today. Like you can see, our AI agent uses now the Google Sheets tool and ChatGPT to answer our question. Like you can see, it answered our question perfectly. The only problem is, today is not May 23rd. This is because our agent does not know which day today is. We need to pass this information to our agent. For that, we double click on the agent. Currently, the prompt for our AI agent is purely the message that we are sending. For example, which tasks are due today? But we can also define our prompt by saying define below and typing in ourselves here. First, we need to request which tasks are due today. For that, we just drag and drop the chat input here. But now we're still missing the information what day is today. For that, we go back to our Google Docs document. And copy and paste this little snippet here. And like you can see, our prompt is now which tasks are due today, and the information today is this date here. Now let's try it again. Which tasks are due today? And like you can see now, our AI agent knows exactly the day and can answer our questions regarding the tasks. But with the current setup, our AI agent cannot remember anything. So for example, if I would ask him now, which of these tasks should I do first? We see it says to determine which task you should prioritize, I need to know what tasks you have on your list. He answers this way because he can currently not remember the conversation of the text. For that, we need to add a memory. So let's close this, click the plus icon here and select simple memory. Here we can leave everything like it is and go back to Canvas. Now let's try again the chat. First, let's clear this complete chat and ask again, which tasks are due today? Great, it gives us the same answer. And this time we ask again, which of these tasks should I do first? Now ChatGPT can give us an answer that is based on the previous conversation. Like you can see, it gives us now some information which task we should do first. So for example, it says the car maintenance has a high priority while the cleaning garage is medium. Let's close this one. Our AI agent is already much smarter than when we started. But we're not done yet. The next two quick steps will make it way more intelligent, so don't skip them. Right now, the AI agent can read our Google Sheets document. But if we ask him to add a new task, he won't be able. Let me show you. When I ask him, can you add a new task for today to bring out the trash? He will tell us, I've added the task, bring out the trash for today. But it's not true, he's hallucinating. Let me show you. Like you can see, he didn't add any tasks here. That's because we still need to give it one more tool. And look again for Google Sheets tool. This time, under operation, we select append or update row. We have to again to provide the document. We select by URL. Copy and paste it here. Under sheet, we select again tasks. Now we scroll down here. Under column to match, we select task. And for values to send, we select for all four, let the model define. That's it. Let's go back to Canvas. And let's try it again. Now we see the AI agent uses this new tool. And let's check if it worked this time. And we see bring out the trash is a new task in our list. The next step is even more powerful. It will make our AI agent much smarter. For that, we go back to our Google Sheets document and copy the advanced prompt here. We go back here to our canvas, double click on the AI agent and just replace the prompt with our new one. Click go back to canvas. And now our agent is already much, much smarter. It now gives better answers, shorter answers, does not repeat questions, and is overall more insightful. Feel free to play around with the prompt and adjust it to your needs. Let's save the current state. The next thing we will do now is to make our AI agent available through WhatsApp. This way you can chat with your AI agent through WhatsApp, or even share it with friends and family or clients. But before we start, let's have a little theory about what are AI agents and what are workflows. First workflow. A workflow is a linear rule-based process which ensures that actions are executed in a defined sequence with a defined output. A typical example would be a customer support workflow. For example, a new email comes in, then a chat model decides what kind of email it is. If it's a refund, then we first have to find the order by email. Then we check if this order is eligible for a refund. For example, if the order is like 60 days old, it's not. Then the system decides if it's eligible for a refund, then we issue directly a refund automatically and send an accept refund message. That's simple, but has a problem. So it always runs the same way. The steps are aligned in a strict order and cannot be skipped. It's easy to measure and control. This is a really good point. It ensures consistency, but can struggle with unexpected changes. For example, when the email type is not one of these three, our system cannot work. Here, AI agents come into play. AI agents, on the other hand, are like intelligent systems. They adapt to steps based on data or goals. Let's take a look again at the customer support example. Here, we also get a new email. But this time we have an AI agent that orchestrates all steps because it has access to all tools. Plus it has a chat model who can decide based on instructions that we also give them, which steps to execute in which order to achieve the goal. And at the end, we send a feedback back. You might wonder why we have here a tool that sends email and also have something that sends feedback. It's because, for example, imagine not a new email arrives, but a new WhatsApp chat message arrives and the customer wants to cancel his order. So for that case, the AI agent will probably first find the order, then refund it, and then send a confirmation email that this order is canceled. And at the end, send through WhatsApp the feedback, your order is canceled. All right, now let's make our AI agent available through WhatsApp. For that, we remove our current trigger by clicking the trash bin icon. Next, we click the plus icon here and select a new trigger for our workflow. We type in WhatsApp and select WhatsApp Business Cloud. And as a trigger, we select on messages. Here, first, we have to fill out our credentials by clicking Create New Credentials. We need the client ID and the client secret. How to get both, I explain a step-by-step guide in another video you can find in the description box. I simply copy and paste it here and click Save. When everything worked correctly, you should see this message here. Connection tested successfully. We close it. Important, do not connect this trigger now directly to the AI agent before you clicked Execute Workflow. I will now send a message through WhatsApp to trigger this element. When everything worked, you should see here a green check mark. Now let's double click on this element. Here on the right side, we see now all the information received from WhatsApp. But for us, our only interesting contacts, because here we know the name and the WhatsApp ID, and messages, because here we can find the actual message we just sent under this variable. For now, we go back to Canvas. Now we can connect our trigger to our AI agent. Now let's double click on our AI agent and click under prompt this little icon. Here we can see our prompt that will be sent later to ChatGPT. But since we changed the trigger, we now have here something red. That means the variable is not available anymore. This is because our chat trigger is gone. We have a new trigger. Let's delete this variable and drag and drop our text variable from WhatsApp here. That's it. We can close now. Here we also have nothing to adjust. We can go back to Canvas. And now we have to do one little more thing. We have to go to our simple memory and change the thing under session ID. We need now to select define below, and as key, we select WhatsApp ID. This enables us to have multiple conversations and each are separated. For example, when I'm personally chatting with my AI agent, there's a different memory and a different chat context than when somebody else is writing it. We go back to Canvas. And we can now test if our AI agent works by double-clicking on it and clicking Execute Step. Like you can see, everything worked. But one little thing is missing. We want now to send back this message to WhatsApp. For that, we go back to Canvas and click on this plus icon. Here we search for WhatsApp and select WhatsApp Business Cloud. And under Actions, we select Send Message. Here we have to fill out the credentials again. We click Create New Credentials and simply copy and paste them here. And click Save. When everything worked correctly, you should see the message connection tested successfully. Next, we have to select our sender number. We select test number. Under recipient's phone number, we go to our WhatsApp trigger and look under contacts and select WhatsApp ID and drag and drop it here. And the last thing we have to do is to define the return message. For that, we go here up and drag and drop the output from our AI agent. That's it. We click now execute step. And you should now receive a message on your WhatsApp.